Good morning, students. So in this class we will finish the chapter 4. Okay, so this part is part 3. Okay, so it was chapter 4, the peninsular plateau. So in our previous classes we were discussing about the various states that come under the peninsular plateau. We have already discussed about the states, and let us discuss or know about the remaining states, that is they are Karnataka, okay, then Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So we already discussed about Maharashtra, okay. So Karnataka lies to the south of Maharashtra. Okay. So its capital name is Bengaluru. Okay. So the previous name was Bangalore. Now it is Bengaluru. Bangalore. So now it is Bangalore. Bangalore. Okay. And there are also some famous cities, okay, big cities are there. So the names of the cities: Mysore, okay, Hubli, Bijapur and Dharwad. Okay, so these are the names of big cities that lie in the state of Karnataka. Then the various rivers that flow through the state Karnataka. So Krishna, Tungabhadra and Kaveri are the three rivers flow through this state. Then crops. When we talk about the crop or the cultivation of the people of Karnataka, we can see that most of the people are farmers. They are, okay, are farmers. So different types of crops they grow, like cotton, sugarcane, coffee, spices and jowar. Okay, so these are the names of crops that are grown by the people. Okay, and also the forests are full of teak trees and sandalwoods. And another interesting thing that they also made handicrafts by using sandalwood. Okay, so the handicrafts made of sandalwood are very famous in Karnataka. Okay, so besides all of them, there are also another things that the state is also known for its heritage monuments and ecotourism destinations. Heritage monuments and ecotourism destinations. Okay, so besides all these things, the state is also famous for heritage monuments and ecotourism destination. Then next come to another state, that is Andhra Pradesh. So next Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so Andhra Pradesh is also coming under the peninsular plateau. Okay, so Andhra Pradesh is bound on the north by Odisha and Chhattisgarh, on the west by Maharashtra and Karnataka, on the south by Tamil Nadu, and on the east by the Bay of Bengal. So, after the bifurcation of state with Telangana, Hyderabad will remain common capital for not more than 10 years. So, we know that the capital of Andhra Pradesh is Hyderabad. Okay. So, after the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh, bifurcation, BIFURCATION. So, bifurcation means division. Okay, bifurcate means divide, division into two branches. Bifurcation. Okay, bifurcation. So after the bifurcation of state with Telangana, so Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, because before it was under Andhra Pradesh. So after the division of the state, the newly created state Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so Hyderabad is the capital of these two states, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. It is for 10 years, and after the 10 years, Amaravati is supposed, Amaravati has been proposed a new state capital. Okay. So, after 10 years, it will be Amaravati. Amaravati has been proposed a new state capital. Okay, the people mainly depend on agriculture. So its capital Hyderabad. Okay, then crops. So people mainly depend on agriculture. They grow different type of crops: rice, jowar, tobacco, sugarcane, and groundnut. Okay. So, the people mainly depend on agriculture. The state is the largest producer of tobacco in India. So, the state is also a largest producer of tobacco in India. Then, language. So, the language of the people of Andhra Pradesh is Telugu, and Urdu is also spoken in Hyderabad. Then popular dance. Kuchipudi is the popular dance, okay, of Andhra Pradesh. Then tourist places. There are also many tourist places. Charmina, Solar Jung Museum. Okay. Then, Venkateswar Temple at Tirupati is a famous pilgrimage center. Okay, so this is all about the state Andhra Pradesh. Then come to the next one. So Tamil Nadu, its location. Okay, Tamil Nadu is bounded on the north by Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, and on the west by Kerala, on the east by the Bay of Bengal, and on the south by the Indian Ocean. So it is the location of the state Tamil Nadu, and it is famous for temples. Okay, so Tamil Nadu is famous for temples. The main temples, the main temple towns are the towns like Madurai, okay, Thanjavur, okay, Thanjavur, then Tiruchirappalli, okay, and Kanchipuram. So these are the towns in which we can see a lot of temples. Okay, so these are the main temple towns. Then the capital of Tamil Nadu, Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu. Then another thing that it is famous for silk sarees. So these are the centers like Kanchipuram, okay, and Madurai are the main centers of silk weaving. Okay, so these are the two centers for producing silk sarees. They are famous for, and they grow different type of crops like rice, sugarcane, and cotton. Then groundnut, rice, sugarcane, cotton, and groundnut. Okay, so most of the people of the state are farmers. They depend on agriculture. Okay, then also tea and coffee are also grown along the slopes of the Nilgiri Hills. So along the slopes of the Nilgiri Hills, okay, tea and coffee are also grown. Okay, then other things about Tamil Nadu, like its popular dance. Okay, Bharatanatyam is the very popular dance in Tamil Nadu. Okay, then festival Pongal is a festival that is most popular festival in Tamil Nadu. Then the food habits of the people. So people eat rice, idli, dosa, upma, sambar, and curd. Okay, so these are the names of their food that it's famous by the people of Tamil Nadu. Their language spoken by the people. Tamil is the main language spoken by the people of Tamil Nadu. Then major tourist centers. So Mamallapuram, okay, Kanchipuram, Chidambaram, and Otti, and many other places are the major tourist centers. Okay, so these are the names of major tourist centers. So in this video we learned about the various states that come under the peninsular plateau, like Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and last Tamil Nadu. So with this we end our chapter 4. Okay, so in our next class we will start the next chapter, that is chapter 5, India, the Great Indian Desert. Okay, so thank you. So go through the book and do the exercises A and B. Okay.